when we last talked about the Gabby Petito story, and we had our theories and what happened and whatnot, and it was pretty obvious that that girl was dead. And we said that she was dead, right? And so she turned to be dead, right? And we never really commented on the case past that point because what was the point of it? But the Brian Laundrie stuff, I feel like deserves an actual conversation. And I'm going to explain why. I was tweeting, at least. I don't remember if I said it on the podcast, but I was tweeting the moment he left home, right? So remember, they go somewhere. He comes back to Florida with the van, without her. And then, you know, he's not talking to the police. Like 3 or 4 days after that, he goes missing on like a Thursday. And, you know, people are looking for him. I said on my Twitter for a fact, oh, he's dead. Mm-hmm. I said he's dead. I said the dude is going to kill himself.
So you just thought that you think he just killed himself right away?
Yes. I don't know when he killed himself.
Okay.
Because
I thought that he tried to I honestly thought he tried to escape and live, you know, in hiding for a little while and then maybe killed himself.
No.
Okay.
Yeah, no. The strategy was, I'm going to leave. I'm going to be away from the hysteria. And then I knew the guilt was probably so overwhelming for him, you know, regarding what he did, allegedly. Mm. You know, he's dead, but whatever. And because of that guilt, he took his life. I'll be stunned if the ME reports anything other than death by suicide.
Yeah.
Stunned. This is shocking for me.
Do you still think do you think he just ran away, or do you think the parents helped him go away?
So this is the second part that I want to talk about here, because mm-hmm. the parents are catching a lot of heat on social media, and I don't understand why.
I think why? Because he came back to their house where, didn't she live with them, Gabby?
Yes.
With the van, shouldn't they be concerned as to where she is? And I don't know. I think, and the fact that they wouldn't talk to her family, really, I feel like that is, you know, I feel like that's wrong. So I feel like I understand why the parents are catching heat because of their lack of consideration in the whole thing.
Their number one priority is their son.
Okay. But so,
what do you mean? But Shannon, if your son came to you, let's just fast forward 20 years from now, right? No, in your case, 30 years from now. 30 years from now. So your son comes home. No, I'm saying because, yeah, like, you know.
I'm not having kids, so let's not even throw those hypotheticals out there.
Fine. Somebody you know has kids, right? A close person. Your brother, right? Your brother has a son, right? 30 years from now, right? Mm-hmm. His son, and this works perfectly because I don't know if you watched the interview that Brian Laundrie's sister gave, but woo! So anyway, your brother has a son, right? He went on a trip with this girl, blah, 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 blah. He comes back with the van, without the girl, right? I think me and you kind of know he told his parents something bad happened to Gabby. Or do you think he just... Yeah, okay, so cool. Uh-huh. We agree on that point. What would you want your brother to do about his son?
I don't know. But I talked to my parents about this, and they said that they're going to turn their... They said that they would have turned him in. That they would turn my brother in if he did something like that.
Really?
If he murdered, yeah. If he murdered someone, that's what they said. I don't know if that's actually true. I said that it might be different in the moment if it's actually happening to you based on if you're just giving your commentary. But I don't know.
I think it is easier said than done. Mm-hmm. I think many people think that they would turn in their son. But I think under the right circumstances, how the story plays out, what you hear, that's not a point. Like, we don't know what he told them. Because, depending on how the story is told, you can kind of come across as this was a tragic accident. And here's the thing. If it's a tragic accident, nobody wants their son or daughter in jail. Even if you knew that this person ended somebody else's life, if they explained it in a manner where, you know, they're very sympathetic, they... Mm-hmm. You know, said, you know, I didn't mean to do X, Y, and Z, yada, yada, yada. It just happened. I lost my mind. It was, you know, like, why would you then subject your son to prison? I don't think I really understand how bad prison is. Mm-hmm. prison is pretty bad. So if it's me, I'm not turning in my son. Unless I get the vibe that this was like a cold-blooded, you got to pay for your sins type of, you know, situation. But if I thought that this was...
strangled her, so...
Yeah, but you could strangle somebody because you lost control.
Okay.
No, I'm saying, Shannon, me and you into a fight. We get into a fight. You're swinging at me. I'm dodging. You know, you pick up something off the ground, whatever. I grab your throat. Like, in the heat of a... And this is what I'm saying. In the heat of a dispute, dude, you can easily, especially... And this is something that men don't really think about, that the average man... could kill the average woman with his bare hands in like 10 minutes. But most men don't think of themselves like that. Like you don't think, but like in a heated, you know, argument, then it gets physical. She's swinging at you. You swinging at her, you dodging, you know, think like you can, get your hands and then you lose it. And, or do we know if it was hand strangulation or was it behind the back strangulation? Because
I don't know.
Do we know that as well? And so, this is what I mean when I say, depending on the story I hear, I could easily see me. Now, I would never put myself in a position where I end up going to jail for my child. That ain't going to happen. But, that would be dumb. And I don't think the Laundries did that either. I don't think the Laundries did anything because they got the lawyer pretty early on. So there's no way that the lawyer would have allowed them to do anything that would criminally impact them or their son. I don't believe that. So I would never do anything for my child that would put me in prison. That said, though, I also would not actively help the law imprisonate my child either. If I felt like this was a tragedy and not like my son is a monster. If I get the feeling from the story that my son is a monster, I might work with the authorities. But if he explains it to me in a way where he's like, you know, telling me the story, it sounds very sympathetic, yada, 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 I could easily see me saying, well, look, man, I'm going to pray for you. You know, we're going to get you a lawyer. And, you know, whatever happens, we're going to let it happen. Bing, bang, boom. But people out there mad that the parents weren't actively working with authorities. And I'm like, y'all must not have kids.
They probably don't. Or maybe they do, but they're just, you know, they're just not thinking about it that way. Because they're not in the situation. So, you know.
Yeah. But yeah, you know, this is the end of the Brian Laundrie case. There was also a story that said authorities found 9 bodies while they was looking for Gabby.
Yeah, I know.
That's wild.
It is.
9 bodies. No media coverage.
Nope.
None.
Nope. Nope.
So, you know, like we see, you know, thoughts and prayers to both the Petito family and the Laundrie family. I believe this is a tragic story. I believe the eventual true crime docuseries that comes out is going to be incredible. I don't know who's going to have it first. Netflix, HBO, Lifetime, Hulu. I don't know who's going to get it first, but that is going to be a... Dude, because this story is still insane when you think about like what happened, how fast it happened, how people are projecting onto the couple. Like, it's crazy, but yeah, you know.
Yep.
Goodbye.